Hello guys, what's up? I hope you are doing well and welcome back to Coding Rail. And today we will see some cool and exciting stuff that is nothing but some pattern programs. So without wasting any time, let's get into the program. So let's get started. Let's create one new Java class for that. Call it pattern 1. So here we have to create multiple pattern according to number. Okay, so let's import our scanner class because we will import our number from the user side. Now we have scanner class, just we need to create scanner class object. Yes, we got it. Let's print some message for user. Enter any number. Take it in n variable. That's it. And here we have to start implementing our pattern concept. So before going to start, I must tell you one thing, that we will take the input from the user side, we'll store it in n, and we will use this number as frequency, or you can say the length of our pattern. How much star will be there, it will be depend on that number n. Initially we will print a basic pattern, that is star pattern. You may definitely heard about this, the star triangle pattern. So let's try to implement that. Equal to n. And inside our inner loop, j is equals to 0. Here we have to make sure we will use only print, don't use println, otherwise it will print each star in a new single line. So let's print star, and once our inner loop completed, we have to say println for new line. Let's enter 5, it will give you square pattern. See, 5 for row, 5 for column, 6 because we are taking n less than as equal to, so 0 to 5. But here we need to print triangle. For that we have to make some changes here. Here we will say I. Let's try to run it. Let's enter n. Yeah, we got the exact output. Now if I'll give one space here, let's see. Yeah, this is looking better. So now this is the one kind of pattern, but what I really wanted to create here, let's run it again with some bigger number. I don't want to fill this triangle with these stars. I want to print like as an outline. So let's try to implement that. For that we need to give some condition here. We want star in first column and in the last, and this last column is nothing but I equals to j. Here I is 0, j equals to 0. Here I is equals to 1, j is equals to 2, I 3, j 3. And this thing we can give here, if j is equals to 0, then print this. If j and I is equals to 0, then print star. And if I is equals to this n, whatever the number we are giving here, the last number, we can say the if I is equals to n, then print star, and rest of all give space. So let's implement it. If I is equals to j, or and j is equals to 0, then we will print star, and else we will say space, and make sure it should be print. Let's run it. Yeah, as you can see, this is looking pretty much good, I think. Let's give one more space here. I think it will work. Yeah, this is looking perfect. Now one more condition left here. I told you for last row we have to say here else if I is equals to n. If I is equals to n, we will print the same. Let's see what happened. Let's print for 10. Yeah, bingo, we got the correct output as we wanted. I told you I don't want to print the filled triangle. I want the triangle with only outline. So here guys, you have the main concept for this triangle. This is my favorite program, I must tell you. We can change the design also. Let's give one some space here. Yes. So if I'll say it should be n, or greater than equals to 0, and let's decrement it, we will get some different pattern. See, and if we'll do the same with second for loop, minus minus. Yeah, see, and let's change only first 0, equals to n, increment it, let's run it, print for 10, let's make it 0 equals to n j plus plus. Again we got that same. So without changing this concept, you can change only for loop condition, you will get different pattern. So I hope you understood the concept, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, then please like this video, subscribe it, and share with your friends. I'll see you on the next video guys. Till then, bye bye. This is Coding Rails signing off for now. Thank you.